Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. higher than Vishnu Sahasra Nama is Ram Nama, higher than Ram Nama is Krishna Nama. And this Gauranga Nama is the combination of all names. Sarva Nama Phalam Labhe. All the fruits is achieved by chanting Gauranga. So in Navadvip, that is 4 hours from Calcutta, Lord Shiva, you know when Sudakshin, the Kashi Naresh's son, he wanted to burn Dwarka to avenge the death of his father, because Krishna has killed the Kashi Naresh in the battle. So he did some countering Yajna, and a big Asura came, his name was Sudakshin, and he said, you go and kill Krishna in Dwarka. And the Asura went to Dwarka, but Krishna revealed the Sudarshan Chakra, so the Asura was running back. And he came back and he burned the whole of Kashi. Whole of Banaras, it was burned. So Shiva was saying, where will I stay now? In Kali Yuga. Where will I go? So Shiva left the Kashi Banaras and went to Navadvip. 4 hours from Calcutta. There he resided in Harihar Kshetra, in the home of Lord Harihar. The difference between Krishna and Shiva, what is the difference? Anybody knows? Kannada, can you come here? Maybe they will come back. English me of so what is the difference? What is the difference between Krishna and Shiva? And what is the similarity? It is described in the Brahma Samhita that Shiram Yathana Divikara Vishesha Yoga Sanjayate Nahitathana Rasti Heto Yashambhutamapitatasamupaitikaryat Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bajami. They're just like milk and curd, dood and dahi. The dahi comes from the dood for performing special function. Special preparations are made from dahi which cannot be made from milk. Transformation of dood is dahi. Similarly, Krishna transforms to take charge of the seva of devastation, initiation, tandava, filter. Then Krishna becomes Shiva. When he gets transformed to become the in charge of the mode of ignorance, tamoguna, sattvaguna and rajoguna. There are three gunas. Tamoguna's controller is Lord Shiva, and rajoguna's controller is Brahma, and sattvaguna's controller is Krishna. So all three gunas are controlled by the three guna avatars. So Krishna is responding to Shiva, Sadashiva, Rudra. There are 11 Rudras. Out of that, one Shiva has 5 heads. This Shiva is known as the Lohit Shiva. 5. There are 11 different kinds of Rudras. So in that way, the Lord is expanding into many forms to perform particular function. So we have to understand that actually Lord Shiva and Lord Krishna is like God and Him. There is no difference. One accepts Lord Shiva but does not accept Krishna. He is taking only half the knowledge. One accepts Krishna but does not accept Shiva. He accepts God but doesn't accept the devotee. One accepts the devotee but doesn't accept God. What is it? So that is real knowledge. So Dharma Sanskrita Hakum Sam Vishwakshena Kathasuya Nosa Devi Hadim Shravaivani Kevalam. Whatever effort we do in life, we are working hard day and night. And temples like this are very good places to come and develop some attraction for God. The main beauty of the temples is described in the Bhagavatam, that Bhikshu Sena Katha Surya. Always Kirtanam and Katha should go on. It should be a spiritual oasis when anybody comes, because the goal of all our activities during the day is to come in the evening and hear the Katha of the Lord. Bhikshu Sena Katha Surya. To participate in that. Otherwise, all our activity is Shrama Evahi Sevana. Just like, you know, one person got a cow in his home. And he was trying to remove it. But the cow did not give milk. And he used to feed the cow day and night, but there was no milk from the cow. So what is the use in maintaining the cow? Is there any use? No. Similarly, there is no use of our occupational duties, our working hard all day and night, if we don't develop attraction to hear about God. If we don't develop attraction to chant the name of God, then there is no meaning to our activity. Even the donkey is working hard. People say in night of they work so hard, day and night, and then they come in the night and say, Swamiji, I am a karma yogi. I am working very hard. That's why I have become karma yogi. But my dear sir, just by working hard, you cannot become karma yogi. If working hard you become karma yogi, then the donkey will become karma yogi first. Because we are working so hard, all the laundry and all the bricks and, you know, everything is done on his body. Real karma yoga means there has to be connection with God. Yad ashnati yad juhosi yad karoshi vidasyat yad tapasyati kauteya tat purushva madarpanam. That is real karma yoga. Karma yoga means that our activity should be connected with God. Whatever we do should be offered to God. Not that we, whatever we work hard, we use for ourselves and then we feel we are karma yoga. Then there is yoga. Yoga means to link. Youth. There is no link. If we simply work for our own satisfaction, but we do not worship God, we do not chant His name daily. Lord Krishna is saying in the Gita, you don't change your activity, you do whatever you are doing, but offer it to me. Yes, Karoshi, yes, Ashna, yes, Juhu. Whatever you do it for me. Whatever you eat, you first offer it to me. Who does not eat daily? Who is not eating? Everybody is eating. So whatever you eat, please offer it to God and then eat. It will become happy. Otherwise, all karma will be transferred. Yes, Karoshi, yes, Juhu. Yes, tapasya, whatever tapasya you do, traveling in Bangalore is a big tapasya, so much tapasya. So that is also tapasya. Whatever tapasya you do as an offering to Him, to Krishna, to God. Yeah, yes, Kurusva, Mother Padam. Then it will become. Why you should do that? Because Yajna Kaas Karma Yantra Lokayam Karma Vandana. तदर्थम कर्म कौंतेय मुक्त संग समाचर कृष्ण ओ अर्जुन इफ पीपल दे डू इट फॉर देमसेल्व्स देन दे विल बिकम द कॉज ऑफ द बॉन्डेज बट इफ दे डू फॉर मी देन आई विल डिलीवर देम फ्रॉम ऑल बॉन्डेज तदर्थम कर्म कौंतेय मुक्त संग समाचर दे विल बिकम डिलीवर्ड. So we should know, we should not change the activity, but we should know how to do the activity. It is known as Kushala Karma now. If the thorn is going in our foot, how do we remove the thorn? By another thorn. Similarly, because of karma, we are getting bondage. So how do we become delivered from the bondage? by doing the same karma for power. The activity is just as to be routed and channeled in the service of God. Then it becomes spiritual. So, the first stage in human life is to inquire. उदयसारुष्टोऽहं भवद्भिर्लोकमङ्गलम् यत्कृतः कृष्णतः प्रश्नो येनात्मा सुकृतिर्गति. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इन ह्यूमन लाइफ इज टू आस्क हू इज गॉड, हू एम आई, आफ्टर डेथ व्हाट विल हैपन टू मी, आई डोंट वांट डिजीज, व्हाई डिजीज इज कमिंग टू मी, आई डोंट वांट ओल्ड एज, व्हाई एम आई बिकमिंग ओल्ड. एनीबडी इज आस्किंग दिस क्वेश्चन? You are asking the question, who are you? Who are you? You know? Very difficult. We are trying to give ourselves happiness, but we do not know who we are. One person wrote a very nice quote. He got a very nice new quote from the shop. And he is wearing the coat in front of the mirror and brushing the floor day and night. But he forgot to feed himself. He is just brushing the coat whole day and night. So what happened? He forgot to eat. Then what will happen? He became weak and he was about to die. His wound was very new. It was very nice. So inside he was dying. So he forgot to feed himself. So whole day and night we are feeding the body. We are giving so many nice things to the body. Take this, take that. And who is feeding the soul? Actually we are the soul. Aham Brahmasmi. Tatvamasmi. Aham Brahmasmi. I am that undivided. So we just keep on oiling the parts of the machine. It's about what we do not care about the controller, the sanchalak of that machine. Then we will have to suffer. It will always be a machine. So what is the way to become happy? What is the way to become happy? Inquire about God. When Vyasadeva, he wrote all the Vedas and Puranas, he divided the Veda into four, Sama Veda, Yajur Veda, 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 Veda. And then he wrote the Vedanta Sutra in four. And then he wrote the Upanishads, 108 Upanishads. Then also he was not satisfied, Vyasadeva. So then he wrote with the author 1 lakh verses of Mahabharata. But then also he was not satisfied. Then he wrote the 17 Puranas. Then also he was not happy. Then he was sitting on the bench of the Saraswati and thinking, I have written so many books but I am still not satisfied and not happy. So his Gurudev Naradji came and Naradji chastised Vyasadeva. You are not happy because you have not directly inquired about Krishna. You have not directly glorified Krishna in any of your books. In the Vedas, you have indirectly talked about Krishna. In the Upanishads. So, Namah Nishan Kitaji, Srimad Vidyaya.
is happening.
And my dear Vyasa, now you write the 18th Purana, the Mahapurana, the Srimad Bhagavata Mahapurana, Mahalam Prema, Bhavarko, Mahan. You write this Srimad Bhagavata, which should directly talk about the activities of Lord Sri Krishna. And you don't go in roundabout way, directly talk. And then by writing that you will become very happy. Those who hear Srimad Bhagavatam, they will become very happy. Yes, Prasad Krishna. The first sutra of Vedanta. What is the first sutra of Vedanta? Anybody knows? Adhato Brahma Jiva. The first sutra of Vedanta is that one should inquire about the absolute truth. When we are sitting in the message of God, we are actually inquiring. Even hearing is actually inquiring. So, everything starts by inquiring. If one does not inquire, then the Guru will never speak. The whole Gita, Arjuna is inquiring, the whole Srimad Bhagavatam, Shukadeva Goswami is asking, that is why Parikshit is speaking. So, if Parikshit is asking, that is why Shukadeva is speaking. So that is the Prani Patena Pari Prashnena Sevaya Udekshan Vivekyana Jnanayanta Prashnena. The first step to learn about God is to approach the Guru. Arjuna wanted to hear the Gita, so whom did he approach?
He went to Krishna.
Krishna said, no Arjuna, and Krishna tested Arjuna. He said, whom did he ask this question? But Arjuna said, no, Krishna Bhande Jagat Guru. Shreyasya Nishitam Bhuhi Tatme Shishyaste Ham Sadhivam Nam Pradhanam. Oh Arjuna, no Krishna, I am becoming your Shishya. Then only Krishna started the Gita. In the time Arjuna was feeling that Krishna is on the same level. On my same level, in my brain, Krishna was not speaking the Gita. When Arjuna accepted Krishna as Guru, and he became a disciple, humbly, then Krishna started to Kanari Vajishna Prasvanta Kirtita Arjuna Prajya Adam Sabhashita. Yo Arjuna, you are speaking very very learned word, but you are actually good. Foolish. Cowboy. So, then one wants to know the science of God, one has to approach a teacher. Can you learn anything in life without a teacher? Okay. Even if you want to do cooking, we have to go to cooking. Anything? So, that's the key pradipatena. Now let people know, I will directly try to understand God. If God is directly in front of you, you will never come. Even if you are not in front of you, then you will never come. Those who directly try to know me, they are never my devotees. So to approach my devotees, to learn about me, they are my actual devotees. And how to approach the teacher? First, we should approach in a humble mood. Pari prashnena sevaya. One should approach in a mood where one should inquire question. One should ask a question in a humble mood. Sevaya, how should I serve God? How do I understand my relation with God? Who is God? Who am I? What is my relation? These are questions one should put before the Guru. So nobody else can answer this question. You should go and ask the shopkeeper. Who is God? Can you tell me? No. Who is God in the soul? For that one is to go. Who is darkness? Antaka and Ru. He is one of the advocates. Guru. So Guru is always heavy with knowledge, but not a puppet in the hands of the defendant. nowadays, all disciples want the Guru to be perfect. So they come to the Guru and say, I will give you 60,000 rupees, then give me that Ashirvad which I want. Guru is also in place. Okay, just tell my point. That is not Guru. Guru sometimes speaks strong words of the disciple. He does not hear that whether the disciple will be staying or going away. The teacher sometimes has to, you are a teacher, you know, when children misbehave, one has to, so it will never improve. So, Hari Krishna is a devaya. The Guru is soft like the rose and sometimes hard like a thunderbolt for the benefit of the disciple. You don't correct somebody on the street, the stranger. You correct somebody whom you are connected with. That is also sign of love and affection. So the first question in life we should ask, that what is going to happen after death? I am working so hard. Will anything come with me? What I am accumulating? Will anything come with me at the time of death? Krishna Pariyamad Pankaja Panjantam Adaya Vishukumenasa Raja Hamsa Dana Prayana Samayi Kapamitta Vatayi Kantava Rodhana Vidho Smaranam. King Kulashekhar, he was from South India. He was asking, he was praying to Krishna, that my dear Krishna, when I become old, my throat will be choked up with mucus and I will hardly be able to speak and breathe as I become old. At that time I may forget you, and if I forget you and if I die, then I will get a very bad destination. In the last moment, one should remember Krishna. Otherwise, what is the goal of human life? Whole life, one may do so much religiosity or so much hard work, but at the end of life, one will forget God. What is the use? Death is the exam of life. So we are all preparing for that final exam. But people of this world, they say, oh, don't worry, after death everything is finished. Why to worry? No, after death, the soul gets another body. Vaknam Sijanam, Yathavi Jai, Yathavi Sharinam, Yathavi Jiranam, Anyan Sanyan, Bhavani Devi. The soul, just like we take new clothes in the morning, the soul will go to a new body at the time of death. So we should prepare from now what body I am going to get in my next life. That we should prepare from this life. Now we have got the time. And the old age is coming, we have no time. It is already very late. So Kulashekhar, King is saying that, my dear Krishna, now I am thinking of you. But there is no guarantee that in the old days I will think of you. Better let me die right now. So he is praying like that. Nobody has ever prayed. He is saying that Advaita Vishnupaya Manasa Raja Hamsa. My mind is like a swan. It is in the gone in the petal, that stem of your lotus feet. The swan has entered, so I can paint the nectar of your lotus feet. And I relish the nectar right now. You know, there was a sage, I told you the story in Bangalore. One sage, he gave four kinds of ashirvad, four different kinds of inspiration. He went to a town and many, many disciples were following him. One, Rajkumar came, sitting on the horse. No prince, he was riding the horse. So he came. And the prince asked him for blessing. So the prince said, Mahavara, don't die. So the prince was very happy. He offered a kind of
butcher, he was killing this cow meat daily.
In the destruction of Gopalwar. So, it is very easy to chant. 108 beads every month. If you have a mala at home, just catch it in the middle finger like this. Put the bead in the middle finger of the middle part of the middle finger and start from the big side. From the big side, one should start. And from one bead, one should chant one mantra. Nityananda, 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 Nityananda. Like that, one will come this side, one will finish 108 times. That is known as one mala. One grantha is char mala. So one mala is 108 times. And then from here, one should turn back. One should not cross. This is the main thing. Chant for Krishna, one should not cross. One should turn back. Again chant, Gauranga, 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 Gauranga. Like that, one will come here 108 times. So I request you, please try these two mantras. Very, very powerful. You will fulfill all your desires. And then you can chant the Hare Krishna mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. All of you, whenever you find time, please chant this holy name. It will give you all benefit to chant that. And we have Janmashtami tomorrow.
Paper under the sun, will it get burnt? You keep a paper under the sun, it won't get burnt. But
magnifying lens over the paper,
then the sun rays will be focused on the paper, it will be burned. So Krishna also says, Yatani Sarvani Sriyam Yarikta Vasili Yasari Yatriyamani Dasya Pratya Atishtita. And to again me, one should withdraw the senses like a tortoise and focus it on me, then one will attain it very easily. So the statement is Brahmachari is living. And but the Brahmachari's mind is also hankering for other pleasures. So maybe after 5-10 years if we will take up the other pleasures, if we give up the spiritual life, there is no problem. So better let it die right now. Let it be a good destination because it is having control. Okay, we understood that, but why do you go to the devotee and give him this benediction, Jiva Va Marava? That is very simple. A devotee of God, while living also he is serving God. And after the death also he is going to serve God. You know, death for the non-devotee is like the cat or the rat. You know, when the cat coming, the rat, the mouth of the cat looks like death for the rat. So normally those who are not devotees of Krishna, they for them death is very fearful. There was a multi-billionaire, you know, he was dying in the Bangalore hospital. And the doctors, they came to him. He said, Doctor, I will give you 1 crore, you just give me 4 days to live. Doctor said, why do you want 4 days? I want to open another factory and I want to marry my in-law. Doctor said, I'm sorry, he started shivering. People are so much afraid of death. Everyone is afraid of death. So the soul never dies, actually. It's an artificial thing. The soul just goes into another body. So Krishna says in the Gita that one who understands that the soul is simply changing body in the form of death will never become fearful of death. One will become a dhira. Dhira means sober. Sober person. One will understand that I am just going to change. So, do you become fearful when you change dress in the morning? Oh, now I have to dress new dress. You don't feel any fear. Similarly, death is like that. The atma, we are the atma, we are not this body. You know, when somebody dies, we say, no, he passed away. Who passed away? The body is still lying there. Who has come? What do you think? Have you ever thought? He passed away. Why don't you love this body like you loved him before the death? He is there just because you. Because you know, buried, thanks. Because actually, the person who will love has gone away. And who is that? Oh, the atma. It leaves the body at the time of death. Actual love in this world is actually between the atma. Because the atma is in the body, we take care of the body. The echo benignly take care of this body, provide nourishment. But when atma is not there, the body is. I'll give you another example. There was one very rich man going in a big car, and his driver was driving, but that day driver was sleeping, and he banged the car. And there was a big fighting. The driver came out and started shouting, and then the rich man also came out and started shouting. But nothing happened to the rich man. Why the rich man is shouting? It happened to the car. But because he's identifying with the car, that is that he is also feeling hurt. Similarly, we are in this body, and because we identify with this body, all the bodily pains and pleasures actually affect us so much that we actually feel a victim, we feel depressed. Anybody who understands the science of the soul will never become depressed, will never become unhappy. Because one knows the soul is never unhappy. The soul is not chit and anatta. The soul is always full of anatta, bliss. And chit means knowledge, and sat means to save the soul along with the body in this human life. Human life is basically to save the soul. Animals cannot save their soul. Animals don't have any very much. They cannot come inside the temple. So, they cannot understand the Gita. But the human being can understand the Gita. And the human being can understand the soul. So we should try. Kavai Pumsa Karo Dharmo Yoko Bhakti Radokshati Ahayuki Yaprati Nata Yenasma Dhuya. So the greatest dharma of every soul is Bhakti Yoga, is to engage in devotion. Bhagavatam is saying, Kavai Pumsa Karo Dharmo Yoko Bhakti Radokshati. Whom we should do bhakti of, we should not do bhakti of someone who is in the condition. One should do bhakti of adoption. Lord Krishna is adoption beyond the purview of our bhakti. So one should do bhakti of such a personality, then we should come out. How I do me, how Rabbi Allah. And our bhakti should be unmotivated. There should not be any desire. One should do bhakti just for the pleasure of God. It is known as ahaituki. And aprati-nata is non-stop. The spiritual life is not a part-time process. Spiritual life is throughout the day we should be Krishna conscious. Throughout the day we should be connected to God. By chanting His name, by doing some service, because death can come at any time. Anyone knows here when you are going to die? Anybody knows? So much advancement is there, the science and the doctors, but still they cannot tell us when we are going to die. So that is why our spiritual quest, our nama japam should be continuous. By continuous devotion only we can actually satisfy our soul and satisfy God. And automatically by chanting the name of God, automatically we will develop all vairagya, all jnana, everything we know. These are bhakti is Mahadevi and jnana and vairagya are the rudders of Mahadevi. Automatically. And who is having devotional knowledge? What is that devotional knowledge? Bahunam Janmanavante Vasudeva Sarvaviti Samahatma Sukhulabha Iti Mandva Vajante Maam. That one who worships me after many, many lives, somebody will come to real knowledge. And what is that real knowledge? That Lord Krishna is everything. Simple, the knowledge is very simple, anybody can. Even child, if the child says Krishna is the supreme personality of God, then the child is Jnanavan. Vasudeva, Sarvamiti, the Mahatma of Sudhoga. And for such a person becomes a Mahatma. Mahatma, to become Mahatma is very easy. It's not very difficult. To become Mahatma, one has to simply accept Krishna. Mahatma Rastu Mahabhat Daivir Prakruti Mahashukta Bhajanti Anantya Manaso Bhutati Mahabhyam. One has to simply come under the Daivir Prakruti of Krishna. Then one will become Mahatma. By accepting God, by understanding that I am subordinate to God, I am not God, I can never become God. I am always a part of God. Mamai Vamsho Jiva Loke Jiva Purusha. Understanding that I am a part of God and serving Him, chanting His name, then the soul will understand the center Swarupa. Nitya Siddha Krishna Praye Sadha Kavu Noy Sravanadi Siddha Chitta Koi Udai. Krishna Prema is lying dormant in our soul and it cannot be awakened by any artificial means. only by hearing about God. The more we hear, the more we chant His name, the more we associate with His devotees, the more we read the Gita, automatically the knowledge will sprout from within. Only a Udoy. It is not an artificial imposition of the mind. Krishna Gyan, Krishna consciousness, it is there in the soul. By chanting and hearing the name of God, it has to be awakened. Nitya, Nitya, Shravana, Shilpa, Shilpa, Kodiya, Udoy. It is awakened in our heart by Shravana. That is our ear is very important today. So,
I request all of you, we have speakers.